What came before the beginning? For generations, the story of our cosmos began with an absolute wall. Before stars and before light, there was a point of infinite density, the Big Bang, from which everything erupted. Space and time themselves were thought to be born in that single instant. But what if that isn't the full story? What if nothing before our universe wasn't empty, but something far stranger? Physics has begun to peer beyond that wall, challenging our deepest assumptions about reality. This is a journey to the edge of time, to explore the theories redefining nothingness and uncovering how everything may have emerged from it. To understand what might have come before the Big Bang, we first have to appreciate why scientists thought it was an impossible question. The answer lies in Einstein's theory of general relativity. We observe that the universe is expanding, galaxies are rushing away from each other, like points on an inflating balloon. If you run that movie in reverse, the conclusion is unavoidable. Go back 13.8 billion years, and everything in our universe is crushed into a single point of infinite density and temperature, the initial singularity. According to classical physics, this singularity wasn't just the birth of matter, it was the birth of space and time. As physicist Stephen Hawking famously asked, "What's south of the South Pole?" Once you're at the pole, south is meaningless. If time began at the singularity, the word before has no physical meaning. For a long time, this was the accepted boundary of our knowledge. But this idea of a perfect, absolute beginning always troubled physicists. In science, an infinity is often a red flag that a theory is incomplete. General relativity is brilliant at describing the large-scale universe, but it breaks down at the infinitesimal scale of the singularity. This is where quantum mechanics enters the story. To truly understand the origin of the cosmos, we need a quantum gravity theory that unites the physics of the very large with the very small. While that theory is still a work in progress, just applying quantum principles to the universe's birth fundamentally changes the narrative. When cosmologists talk about the nothing that preceded our universe, they don't mean absolute non-existence. They mean something far more active, the quantum vacuum. In quantum mechanics, a vacuum is never truly empty. The Heisenberg uncertainty principle implies that the energy at any point in space can never be perfectly zero. Instead, this empty space is a seething, bubbling soup of quantum fluctuations. Virtual particle pairs pop into and out of existence, borrowing energy from the vacuum before annihilating each other. These fluctuations are real, their effects are measurable. This quantum vacuum, therefore, is not nothing. It's a state without matter, but it has energy, is governed by physical laws, and contains the potential for everything to come. So, what creates a universe if the quantum vacuum sets the stage? One compelling idea is quantum tunneling. In the quantum world, particles can pass through an energy barrier they shouldn't have enough energy to overcome, like a ball appearing on the other side of a hill without rolling over it. In the 1980s, physicist Alexander Vilenkin proposed that the universe itself tunneled into existence. A universe like ours, which appears to have a total energy of zero, where the positive energy of matter is balanced by the negative energy of gravity, could appear spontaneously without violating the laws of conservation. A random quantum fluctuation, instead of vanishing, could tunnel through the barrier of non-existence to become a tiny bubble of space-time. This newborn universe isn't yet the Big Bang. That comes next, with a process called cosmic inflation. Developed by physicists like Alan Guth and Andre Linde, inflation theory proposes that in the first fraction of a second, the universe underwent a breathtakingly rapid, exponential expansion. Driven by the vacuum's energy, the universe swelled from smaller than a proton to the size of a grapefruit in less than a trillionth of a second. This stretching smoothed out the fabric of space and magnified the tiny quantum fluctuations within that initial vacuum state to astronomical scales. those tiny energy variations became the seeds for all cosmic structure. Every galaxy and star owes its existence to a quantum jitter in the primordial vacuum. At the end of inflation, the vacuum's energy was released, creating the hot, dense soup of particles we call the Big Bang. In this modern view, the Big Bang isn't the absolute beginning, it's the fiery aftermath of inflation. The idea that our universe was born from a random quantum fluctuation opens a mind-bending possibility. If it happened once, why not again? This leads to the concept of the multiverse. In models like eternal inflation, the process that created our cosmos never truly stops. The wider vacuum continues to expand, constantly spawning other bubble universes, each potentially with its own unique physical laws. Other speculative theories offer different origin stories. Big bounce models suggest our universe could have emerged from the collapse of a previous one in an endless cycle. Brain cosmology, from string theory, envisions our universe as a membrane floating in a higher dimension, with the Big Bang triggered by a collision with another brain. These ideas show that scientists are actively exploring alternatives to a singular beginning. So what was there before the Big Bang? Almost certainly not the simple, empty nothing of philosophy. It may have been a quantum vacuum, seething with potential and governed by physical laws that permit universes to be created spontaneously. A single random ripple, stretched to unimaginable size by cosmic inflation, became the vast, structured cosmos we call home. The universe did not come from absolutely nothing. It came from the potential for something to exist. We are the legacy of that potential ripple in space-time that grew into galaxies, stars, and ultimately, us. The journey to understand our origins is far from over, but it has already revealed a more wondrous and stranger cosmos than we ever imagined.